very much for everyone for taking some time to join today. I'm not going to take too much of your time, but going to, you know, take a couple of moments to shine a spotlight on our flagship cloud collaboration solution, which is, of course, Webex. I'm not too sure where everybody's knowledge level with Webex lies, but by the end of this call, I think you're going to find yourself almost an expert. So if you use Webex today, I'm going to talk about some new things that are coming. If you've never used Webex before, you're going to learn a lot about it today, and going to end it off talking a little bit about our new best friend in the collaboration world, which is Microsoft, and show you guys how we actually play together very well with that solution. So without any further ado, right, I was going to try not to use the words the new normal, but it's really hard to get away from it. But you know, the way that we were working has been changing from what I've seen really over the past 5 years, right, where users' expectations have really changed because of the proliferation of personal devices and the amount of choice that the application world allows us to really, you know, pick and choose the tools that are best for us to allow us to perform our job to the best of our ability, right? The IT manager really no longer really makes that decision for the whole organization. If I want to use PowerPoint, Prezi, whatever it might be, I have those tools at my disposal. And what we've really seen, of course, over coronavirus is this acceleration to digitization. And with that, it's really started to change these expectations that workers have inside of the workplace, right? So whether people wanted to work from home or not, I think the world has realized that working from home is absolutely a viable option. And now we're starting to see the expectations already change inside of employees, right? So I should be able to, you know, schedule this remote work to be productive. Again, this new emerging smart workforce, this millennial workforce, wake up and practically live on their mobile device. That is their mission critical tool. And we're going to be relying on this ability to connect with anyone, any place, anywhere, anytime, under any, you know, roof, with any pane of glass, regardless of whether or not you're in front or behind your firewall, right? That's going to become the new norm, or that's going to become the new normal expectation anyway. And Cisco, Webex, we've been trying to skate where we think the puck is going, to use a real Canadian term there, for quite a while. And, you know, I think you're going to find through the end of this presentation that some of the things that we're doing inside of this platform has really made us in a great position to address what's been going on in the world and really help meet these new needs and expectations for our customers. So again, you know, like I've been saying, employees are demanding better tools now, right? They have this expectation that they should have more choice and this ability to work wherever, as long as they're being productive and meeting those goals for the organization. So the first thing I want to do is just, you know, clean slate, right? Webex has been around for a long time. Maybe that's an absolute blessing, but to a certain extent, that's a little bit of a curse, in that what you see here are a couple screenshots of these variations of Webex that have existed over the years. And sometimes I draw an analogy to say the new PlayStation 5 that's coming out, and what we're looking at here are screenshots of older versions of Xbox, right? And if we were going to compare a new PlayStation to Xbox, or an older Xbox, that wouldn't really be a fair comparison. We want to look at the latest and greatest. So this is really Webex today, right? We've really cleaned up our interface, but more than that, our Webex Cloud is actually a platform that delivers a breadth of collaboration solutions. So Webex is absolutely not just meetings like we see today, but Webex is voice, it is video in the cloud, it is messaging. Even this headset that I'm using here is connected to that Webex dashboard that you see on the display there, and everything in this collaboration platform is controlled through a single pane of glass. So if anybody on this call has used our Meraki product for enterprise networking, we've really tried to Merakify our Webex portfolio and give you a single pane of glass to manage all aspects of your collaboration world. And again, that includes meetings, but it also includes calling, includes our video endpoints, which I'm very passionate about. I came from Tanberg Video Conferencing, so of course I love our video products. And again, what has become an indispensable tool for me, especially in this post-coronavirus world, is our Webex Teams application, which includes our business-to-business or business-to-consumer messaging platform. So again, I'm able to message with people inside and outside of my organization on this one application, and I don't have to worry about logging in or out like a guest account. And again, of course, we are a security company. Some might argue we are one of the best, if not the best security company in the world. So things like privacy and security and personal privacy are intrinsic, and they are a core part of everything that we build in the collaboration world. So true, proper end-to-end encryption is included on all of our collaboration solutions. But again, we have built these solutions to communicate with those that exist outside of your firewall. So we have a very secure, unique way of doing this. But everything that we do, again, is done with compliance in mind, visibility and transparency to the customer, things like enabling them to hold the keys to their encryption. So, you know, should a government, for example, even see some of that information, they can't read it without the keys. Again, I could do a whole webinar on our unique security story. But again, things like Webex bombing have never been a term for a reason, because we've built things like privacy, security, encryption, compliance, visibility into our solution from the ground up. And again, like you're going to see a little bit later when I do a very short demo for you all, Webex is not necessarily, or in fact is rarely, a rip and replace conversation. If there are aspects of the Webex portfolio, whether the whole, you know, suite of products, or even just say you need a cloud calling solution would exist in our portfolio, and that would be something you would want to take advantage of, we could integrate that with the major tools that you use today, whether that be Salesforce, whether that be Google. And again, I'm going to show you a bit of a demo of how well we play with Microsoft later in this call. So again, we have plenty of customers that are taking advantage of our Webex platform, which has been infallible through this coronavirus explosion. If you check a public site like downdetector.com through the past 5 months or so, you'll find that Webex has had the fewest problems out of any of the major online meeting providers. And that is a testament to our solution being built for business as a mission critical tool to keep customers and businesses connected. So again, I could do a whole presentation on how well we responded to the coronavirus pandemic, what a fantastic job we did of taking care of our longtime customers that have always been there for us or been expected of us to be there for them, as well as addressing an explosion of greenfield customers that had never used the product, but again, needed the world's most secure, reliable business-to-business meeting platform. But even though we had to put a lot of effort and focus on making sure that our mission-critical business-to-business tool never went offline during the coronavirus explosion, that didn't mean that we were resting on our laurels. And around Cisco Live, we talked about quite a few things that are coming down the roadmap that we are going to be rolling out and delivering to our Webex customers today. And again, you know, if you're familiar with our Meraki solution, you know that we're constantly innovating on that platform and delivering new features and capabilities to our customers. And that is exactly what we're doing here with Webex. So again, constantly listening to our customers ask and feedback. And like we say, we're focusing on all these little things with tweaks and tailors to make the experience as best as it can be. So as you guys have probably noticed right now that I am using a blurred background here on this call. A blurred background was something that we had available on our mobile devices for quite some time, but now I'm using it here on my laptop. And very shortly, we're going to have some neutral and businessy, I guess I'll say, backgrounds available as well. You know, I think backgrounds are a little bit of a funny thing. When the first time I think I saw backgrounds maybe becoming a little bit of a problem would have been on one of the federal calls that we had about the conversation around banning assault rifles. And, you know, there were certainly some very pro people in a part of that conversation that had chosen some very pro backgrounds as part of their federal calls. And at the same time, there were some that were against it that had also done some very colorful things with their backgrounds, which immediately raised the conversation around what should people actually be doing with backgrounds. And as you guys might have noticed, I did have my 7-year-old coworker here join me a moment ago. And certainly a blurred background would have helped out in that situation. We're going to help out with some more, virtual backgrounds as well. But again, thinking about that neutrality and that business look as part of the conversation. We are going to clean up our Webex interface even more and make our buttons even easier to use, make them stand out a little bit better so it's just that much easier to navigate through a call. And again, this would maybe be a good time to point out that we just asked one of our poll questions here is, hey, I'm sure you guys are having a lot of meetings, maybe to keep it a little bit fun. Hey, who's complaining the most about your current meeting situation? Is it, is it your salespeople? Is it your internal people? Is it your operations folks? Just kind of interest as to where you guys are maybe feeling some friction as you guys have been navigating and transforming through this coronavirus new way of working, I guess. We have a default grid view coming as part of our meeting solution. Now, I will call out, grid view has always been available as part of a Webex meeting. It just wasn't something that we had turned on by default. But again, we're listening to the consumer and even the business expectations as the world has changed. And we're going to make the Brady Bunch view, for lack of a better term, the default view moving forward. And that's coming probably within the next 5 weeks or so. Breakout rooms or video breakout rooms has always been something that has been available in the Webex suite of products. It was really something that we had as a feature of our Webex training platform. So again, there were some sub-products underneath the Webex Meetings brand. There was Webex Meetings, Webex Events, which we're using right now, which has this panelist and attendee type function. And then we had our Webex Training Center, which is very popular inside of the education world. And we had breakout sessions available inside of that product. We're going to be taking that and we're going to be putting that right into our meetings product as well. Again, we recognize that customers are having more and more meetings, and the ability to do this in just your day-to-day meeting is becoming more important. So we're adding that. And then we're even, changing or making some tweaks on the way that we share content as part of meetings so that, me as the host of the meeting who's sharing content and looking at poll questions and chat and what have you, I can manage that information a little bit better. We're tweaking that. And also the ability to, in the middle of a meeting, mute everybody on the call, right? So we've always had the ability to make everybody muted as they've entered the meeting and they've had to manually unmute themselves to vocally participate in the call. Now, in case 2, 3, 4 people have done that and some of them have forgotten to remute their microphones and they're driving, or again, their 7-year-old coworker decides to join them on the call, the host will have the ability to just mute everybody so that having the best meeting experience possible. Again, we've always had a lobby experience. So when I'm in my Webex personal meeting room and I want to make sure that nobody who's not supposed to be part of that conversation can join that conversation, I can lock that personal meeting room. We're updating and augmenting that experience. So again, providing more feedback and making it feel like you're, again, in a little bit more of a virtual waiting space right in your Webex interface, and again, the ability to maybe do a little bit of communication to let people know that you're waiting and allow the host to communicate back right inside of the Webex meeting as well. And then again, we're also adding this lobby experience for video conferencing endpoints or meeting rooms. So we know that there are going to be more and more video conference rooms, huddle spaces now, because we're going to either see customers move to a complete work from home environment or an absolutely more of a hybrid work for environment in the short term. So we know there's going to be more of a need for these meeting rooms to join these web calls, and we're going to provide a lobby experience for them as well. And again, allowing more IT admin features that exist in our simple to use pane of glass, which we call a Webex hub. Again, if you have used or liked the Meraki dashboard and you've never seen the Webex hub, it's absolutely something you need to take for a test drive. And we're going to have the ability to, as you can see here, look at these real-time meeting analytics and even in some cases jump into and join a meeting to see what's going on and better change that experience on the fly, right? So we work with a lot of customers that have, you know, people in the high levels in the organizations, presidents, VPs, CEOs, that, you know, they're really just running and bouncing from meeting to meeting. And this is ways for administrators to, again, you know, become this virtual concierge, if you will, and ensure that all of these meetings are as great as they can be. And then again, we have 5x5 grid layouts coming specifically for Webex rooms and Webex meetings. So again, you know, listening to our customers that are asking for more of these Brady Bunch style views and being able to deliver this across, you know, any pane of glass that's participating in a Webex meeting, regardless of where you're joining from, whether that be a mobile device, a laptop, a meeting room, what have you, and being able to see this 5x5 layout in there as well. Personally, I think anything more than 5x5 gets very busy and makes for a fairly exhausting meeting. And we're certainly starting to hear about this meeting fatigue that's coming. And we want to be conscious of the fact that, you know, for every square that we're adding to that meeting, that's adding another potential layer of fatigue to your call. But again, that's just something from a personal anecdote from being in the industry for quite a while. One of the other major things that we announced at Cisco Live was our Webex Assistant. This was a recent acquisition that we made that is basically adding a virtual AI assistant to all of our Webex meetings. And since we've turned this on inside of Cisco, I can say again, personally, that this has really helped me out a little bit, maybe before my meetings, but absolutely after my meetings. It's made a lot of my post-meeting action and follow-up has now been automated for me and is allowing me to have more time to be productive, you know, doing, not doing things that can be automated. So for example, this is the solution that we have that will provide live captioning inside of a meeting. That captioning again is transcribed along the side as well as in real time. So again, my 7-year-old coworker, for example, starts making a lot of noise and I'm on a call, just like having captions on while you're watching Netflix, makes it a lot easier to be digesting and in some cases remembering that information. You can be watching, seeing who's saying what, and you can, you know, personally even be creating highlights for those meetings. Again, everybody in a meeting sometimes has different things that are important to them. What's important to John might not be important to Sue. And so John and Sue might want to be highlighting different aspects of that meeting. There is also a way to just voice activate and capture meeting highlights. So you can say things like action item for Jim or action item for Lane or follow up for Lane, for example. And these trigger words can be personalized depending again on who they are or what role they're playing. So again, this is where using some of these features makes the follow-up, the after meeting, a lot easier because these breakout items or these action items have been automatically captured by the AI assistant and in some cases, you know, depending on how you have it configured, delivered to the individuals. So, you know, they're getting those highlights in their inbox after the meeting and no one has to manually do that and create that follow-up, which I know Lane is salivating over because he does a fantastic job of following up with everybody's meeting notes and action items on our weekly meetings. And I'm sure he's looking forward to the day that he doesn't have to manually type that out after each one of those meetings and he can get that 15 minutes of productivity back into his week.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So again, this is all done, you know, thinking of, hey, I have a Google Assistant here in my living room. Why can't we be taking advantage of something like that inside of the business world? But at the same time, I don't know how many of my customers are that excited about putting something like an Alexa or a Google device inside of a corporate boardroom as, again, who knows who's listening to that. But I can say with confidence and conviction that when you use this Cisco built solution that saves all of this data encrypted inside of the Webex cloud, which only the customer has the keys for the encryption to. It's a lot safer to start taking advantage of these tools inside of your environment. And again, you know, here's just a couple screenshots of how you can see, right? There's, you get this notification that your summary meeting is available for you, and you can see your transcription and your highlights, all available for you in your Webex dashboard. And again, you know, the ability to search for keywords or actions or whatever it might be, even cross meetings. So great way to, again, start collecting all of this important data that is happening inside of these meetings, or these great ideas that happen, and leveraging, you know, AI in the cloud to make that available to us after the fact, and taking out a lot of that manual work. And then the last thing that I want to share with you is, again, you saw at the front end, and I did this on purpose, I had screenshots of all of our different applications that are available, for example, on the iOS store, done on purpose in that slide so that I can draw this distinction between all of our products. But again, we know that that can become a little bit confusing on the desktop, so we are moving towards this unified application. And I should call out, I believe I've been talking for long enough, that we might have another poll pop up here. Again, yes, so we want to know, you know, who's griping a little bit inside of your organization, but maybe a little bit more specifically, you know, what is their prime complaint? What are they complaining about?
And just a reminder for those that that maybe joined us a couple of minutes late, remember, if you complete these polls, we do have a $100 Amazon gift card for you for attending and participating.
Thank you very much. So indeed, we have, you know, a separate calling application, we have a separate messaging application and meetings application. Now, if you're using Webex Teams like I am, all of those applications exist in one application. But what we're actually moving towards is that unified application for all of those features or capabilities that I just talked about, but it'll just be one app that sits on the desktop, and then each of those applications would be turned on inside of a single app that sits on the desk. So we are, again, constantly thinking about simplicity for our customers. That's something that's always top of mind for us, and that's something that we're working towards inside of our application as well. So again, we are thinking about, you know, all of these different work styles or these business units that exist inside of our customers, and we're trying to think about, you know, for using a Lord of Rings example here, right? One ring that can rule them all, one application or one collaboration platform that can be applied over the entire workforce. And then from that application platform, the right tools delivered to those users. And again, everything that we make can work on a Mac, PC, Android. You know, we work for feature parity across the choice of devices that exist. But what we're trying to provide is one tool that can be managed centrally through a pane of glass, so it's safe and secure. Again, here are a couple screenshots of what this application looks like. You can hear my 7-year-old coworker there has stubbed his toe. Give me just a moment. Beach, you got to go downstairs, bud. Okay, you have to go downstairs. I'm on a call. I have apologized for that, folks. So again, if you've never used the Webex application, this is a screenshot of what it looks like. This can be downloaded for free across our website or any of the iOS or Android stores. But again, what I would of course recommend, that if anything that I've talked about today is something that you're of interest in, talk to your friends at Longview. Everything that I've talked about today, they have the ability to set up a trial for. That can be a 90-day trial. We do Webex calling. We do the Webex assistant that we talked about, Webex meetings, of course. And like I said, I know that some of you on this call are thinking about how are we going to address this new hybrid work style. And through this Webex trials program, we can even deliver a Webex piece of hardware to you as well. And because I know that they've at least won Partner of the Year from my friends at Microsoft once or twice, that a good number of you are probably using Microsoft on this call. And again, like I've talked about, whether it be Microsoft or Google or Slack or plenty of other applications, it's never a rip and replace conversation. But just drilling in quickly on Microsoft specifically, we have a number of Office 365 integrations that play to these vendor strengths and marry Microsoft's amazing productivity, which I use day in, day out inside of Cisco, with our world-class top of the quadrant business-to-business, business-to-consumer collaboration platform, which is Webex. But a little while ago, I want to, you know, give a little bit of airtime to the fact that we've made an announcement where we are now a Microsoft CBI partner, providing even more choice for our customers. So if you like what we're doing inside of the Webex world, and you like our platform approach, our cloud platform approach to solving some of the new problems that we're facing today, we can marry that together and even, you know, back invest into your existing Microsoft investment. So you would have the ability to, for example, join a Webex meeting from a Microsoft Teams environment, whether that be a soft client or a piece of hardware that you might have put into a meeting room today. And then, of course, vice versa, you would have the ability to have Microsoft call into a Webex environment. And we are able to turn on inside of this environment all the things that customers love about Cisco collaboration, our joining experience, how easy it is, our in-meeting experience, and our simple and transparent management for everything that we do. So again, just to, you know, really enforce with you all that I am not blowing any smoke here, and I'm not talking about any vaporware. Here is my Microsoft Teams environment that I have. Actually, this is just obviously in the cloud. But as you can see, I can go down here and I can actually launch a Cisco voice call from right inside my Microsoft environment. I never even have to leave my Microsoft environment or cross-launch anything to actually make this call. Clicking call there will just open my Webex application, and there my call will go. Of course, we do this with our Webex calling solution, but we do this again, of course, with our on-prem call manager solution. So if you're an existing call manager customer today, but you're looking for this type of functionality, we can deliver. And again, you know, I think I can say with a fair amount of confidence and conviction that when it comes to business voice, we are a very good choice. You know, call manager is tried and true around the world. And if you look at what we're doing with our cloud platform with the BroadSoft acquisition, we have a huge install base of mission critical users for voice. So again, something that we can trial and demo for you guys right from the cloud. But again, you know, want to share with you guys here that, again, I have Webex living inside of my Microsoft Teams environment. So I can start a Webex meeting, schedule a Webex meeting, see all my upcoming Webex meetings. I could even embed a Webex meeting right inside of a chat, all without... all without leaving my Microsoft environment. You know, this is something that doesn't get shown off too often, and something that I wanted to share with you all and make you aware that, again, we can absolutely play very well together with Microsoft in the sandbox. And that was just a smidgen of the Microsoft integrations that we have. So single sign-on integration, Active Directory integration, we are very much thinking about how to play with this vendor, and they recognize that we're a great complement to what they do, which is why they brought us into this CBI club. So definitely something that you can talk to our friends at Longview about, as they are veritable experts in both of these brands. So again, our vision for, you know, a good 5 years or so has been transforming teamwork. Right, thinking about the ways that we get together before our meeting, how we connect during our meeting and making that experience the best that it can be. But even more than that, post-meeting, you know, how can we make the follow-up easier? How can we communicate with people that exist outside of our firewall or outside of our organization? And now how can we add AI to that post-meeting experience to make that follow-up even more productive? And again, you know, I've talked about the fact that this has all been done through our collaboration platform. And I believe this platform is, you know, really making us a great choice to address both how are we going to address all our new people that are working from home, as well as how are we going to address all these new problems that we're seeing inside of the office, right? So again, we have AI built into our meeting room. So when I go back to my Cisco office and need to join a web meeting, all I'm going to have to do is stand in front of that device and say, okay, WebEx, join that meeting. I have nothing to touch. I have nothing to disinfect, right? We have things like digital signage and room capacity management built right into our endpoints. So if I'm in an area that my new workplace policy says I'm only allowed to have three people and a fourth person joins the room, I immediately get a visual notification pop up on that display screen notifying us that we're out of policy. And we can even, you know, through the WebEx hub, provide more notifications inside of the industry. Again, all of this can be demoed and trialed through our partners at Longview, right? So again, you know, our differentiators here are we're trying to address our customers' problems through a single transparent pane of glass from a management perspective and a single application from an end user perspective. We're adding these artificial layers of intelligence to make our meetings even smarter. Of course, we've been able to scale amazingly through this pandemic, and security has been something that we've been built in or has been built into this scaled solution from the ground up. And we are all about playing with others in the sandbox, not talking to our customers about how are we going to rip and replace, but what problems do you still have today? For example, who's still complaining inside of your organization and what are they complaining about? And I am very confident that we can solve that with some WebEx peanut butter in the cloud. So with that being said, going to leave you with this quick summary and pass the baton back over to Lane.
Excellent. Thanks so much, Kevin. And a couple questions, actually, specific to this last section, which would be great. The first question came before you got into the Microsoft section, but was around, you know, with a lot of customers moving towards Microsoft Teams, why have a WebEx Teams client? And yeah, I'll let you go ahead and answer that.
Yeah, so again, you know, traditionally, unless I find customers that have done open federation for their Microsoft environment, which open anything in this world sounds a little bit funky to me. Again, inside of my WebEx world, if I want to communicate with someone that exists outside of my organization that I've never communicated with before, all I need is their email address. And if they've never used our WebEx Teams application, they're going to get a notification in that email's inbox saying, Kevin wants to collaborate with you. They can follow that link and join through a browser and see that encrypted asynchronous conversation where I can be sharing documents and what have you. Again, I've been in environments or worked with partners, for example, where they've showed me screenshots of their employees who are doing what I believe is the right thing in using a tool like Microsoft Teams to stay in front of their customers and provide exemplary customer service. But to do so, they've had to log in as a guest inside of that customer's environment. And as a result, they've had to essentially leave all of their customers and even their coworkers an out-of-office message that says, hey, sorry, I'm logged into my customer's environment. If you need to reach me, call my cell phone. And, you know, that's not necessarily how I envision collaboration working, right? Again, in my world, I'm imagining, right, what if that customer had a question that that individual couldn't answer? They'd have to log out of that customer environment, log back into their own environment, et cetera, et cetera. And I solve this problem day in, day out with WebEx Teams by simply adding that knowledge expert that I need to have to address that conversation from my partner right into the conversation. And I know that I'm getting that answer back to my partner faster than I used to in the past. And I don't know, maybe Lane can tell me, but I like to think that it's helping me provide better service for my partner.
Yeah, for sure. And so suffice to say, Kevin, that the Webex Teams client is a competitor, a strong competitor, as you mentioned, some strong advantages over Microsoft Teams. But the point is where customers are moving to Microsoft Teams, if they've made that decision for whatever reason, the Webex still have the ability to integrate and connect with that, and still allows you to use Microsoft Teams with the Webex and get the best of both worlds, right?
Yeah, absolutely, right? It's it's again, that's again why we're asking these questions, because first, maybe 50% of an organization, that business to business communication or that ability to communicate outside the firewall may not be important. But for salespeople or some of the people in my type of role, that's pretty much all I do every day. So, and then I, sometimes I'll draw a quick analogy to my house here where I have three TVs, but I've only added a Sonos device to one of these TVs to improve that entertainment experience, right? So when we consult with our customers, we don't always recommend that everybody needs this tool, but let's augment your seller's bat belt with something that might allow them to perform that task a little bit better.
And the follow-up question to that one, Kevin, is can Microsoft Teams clients join the Cisco telepresence conference room?
So through that CVI integration, that is indeed the functionality that we were enabling. So very similar to what an organization might leverage a tool like BlueJeans or Pexip for, that exact same functionality is just going to be built right into the Webex tool, right? So again, we are all about getting people connected to solve problems faster, to be more productive. And again, now we're starting to think outside of our own silo and connect with some of these other vendor silos to enable that for our customers.
Excellent. And Kevin, another question here is
Sure.
what data analytics can Webex provide about meetings, and what information is available to help us better understand how to optimize meetings?
Right. So indeed, this is why I've drawn these analogies to the Meraki dashboard, because I'm very familiar with that. And I, thought that the transparency and visibility and control that we provided through that was incredible. And then when I saw what we were doing with the Webex Hub and what we've continued to do, that's why I continue to draw these comparisons. So we can see, how many meetings are people having? How are they joining the meeting? What device are they using? What type of audio conferencing are they using? What was the software or operating system that was being run that this meeting was running on? What was the meeting quality per user? Where did we see degradation? And again, if we think about how we compare this with some of our enterprise networking tools, we can see, right, okay, maybe this home user is having continual bad meeting experiences because of the way they're, battling for bandwidth. So maybe we need to, add something like a Meraki Z3 to that environment so that we can do more control there. We're able to see inside of our meeting rooms, again, how many meeting rooms are being booked, how many people are actually attending those meetings through tools like facial recognition. So we can look at, right, are people, say, for example, booking a meeting room and then not attending that meeting? Or is the person that booked that meeting room not attending their own meeting? And like I talked about, we're leveraging all of these tools now to think about new workplace health and safety protocols, and how can we leverage all of these amazing technologies that exist inside of our video endpoints to deliver different outcomes to our customers, like, you're out of compliance for the amount of people that exist inside of your meeting room, right? You're only allowed to have three, but there's a fourth person in there. This is something that we just turned on for free, leveraging our facial recognition technology to say, hey, when there's four faces in the room, there's too many people, and we need to provide a warning. So that would be a good example of that, I think.
So, Kevin, just in relation to that as well, that's great, and
Sure.
some great tools that you can do for COVID, post-COVID in a meeting room.
Yeah.
What things is Cisco doing around enhancing the home user's experience? Is there a home platform, or what's going on from that perspective?
Sure. So that's for why, again, why I'm, using my Cisco headset here, which is hopefully cutting out a little bit of my background noise, making it easier for me to hear you and you to hear me. Again, all of this is managed through that single pane of glass. On purpose, I'm using my laptop for this call because I wanted to show off the blur capability that we have as part of our virtual backgrounds that we're rolling out. But to be honest, I spend most of my day using my desktop video endpoint, as this is a purpose-built tool for this task. So it's doing all of my processing, or we'll say my computation for my video call inside of that device, freeing up these resources on my laptop. So my laptop's actually pretty hot right now because my presentation, my audio, my video, plus all of my other applications are running on it. When I'm doing this on my purpose-built tool, my video conferencing endpoint that I have, my laptop stays cool all the time, for example. So I don't get that hunched over shoulder syndrome. I have more of an eye-to-eye type of experience. And, you know, again, I'm not as fatigued at the end of my day. I like to equate it to my laptop is a Swiss Army knife, and a Swiss Army knife is great, and it can do a lot of things. But if I'm going to be in the kitchen cutting something up, I want to use a real knife. I want to use the right tool for the job. So in a lot of cases, you know, my video endpoint is the right tool for the job, providing a better experience for me. More importantly, providing a better experience for the folks on the phone.
And we've just got a couple more questions left. If you've got any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat window, or if you want to come off mute, you can raise your hand and we can look to bring you off mute for another question as well.
Sure.
Just looking quickly, Kevin, at some of the responses to what do users complain about. One of the big comments is kind of around the Webex training and kind of the interface. Some users find it confusing. What is Cisco doing around that? Do you see any changes coming to that to help improve that?
For the Webex training platform itself, that product?
No, sorry, training for of the Webex. I believe that refers to training of the Webex tool, and then of course the Webex interface, the Webex meeting center, for example, interface. What's happening to make that easier and more? Yeah,
sure.
Easy to use.
So, for example, when I had that slide up earlier, when I was using the web, you're talking about Webex Teams, those were all actually screenshots of new walkthroughs that we're going to have coming out for all of our applications. So when it's the first time using, or even a refresher, you're going to be able to turn on these walkthroughs that will kind of walk you through the application and explain what each button does. However, if you haven't checked out a site that we have called help.webex.com, that is a fantastic end user site that we have, where we have weekly trainings that are facilitated by Cisco individuals that are live. We have VODs on demand, as well as very short, quick videos on how to do certain things, and lots of tutorials and cheat sheets that can be downloaded from that site as well. So help.webex.com. is, again, probably another tool that doesn't get as much airtime as it should, but it is a fantastic resource that we have to, again, for those quick tips and tricks or VODs on how to perform certain tasks.
So, Kevin, one more question here. While working from home, what's your most indispensable tool and why?
Yeah, so... again, I would probably say it is Webex Teams. My role, I work with the channel inside of Cisco, so I'm not customer facing, but I am partner facing, and we're a fairly thin team in the collaboration world. So I work with people coast to coast across three different time zones and that touch all aspects of our partner community. So this, again, Webex Teams application that I use where not only do I have all of my experts in there that I can ask questions to when I get questions asked of me, but I have group spaces. I have, for example, the space where I have almost 500 individuals inside of my partner community, and I call that my information filtered space, and that is where I put all the absolute news that I think my partners need to know. So again, I'm cutting down on the noise inside of my partners' inboxes, and I'm providing to them an on-demand searchable space where they can go to find out all the important collaboration news. And again, one of the things that I think is, really kind of special actually about this space is the amount of partners that I see ask questions and other Cisco partners answer that question for them even before a Cisco person can get there. It's really kind of fostered this unique sense of community that we have inside of the Cisco collaboration world. even though these partners are in almost every case competitors, they're all kind of pitching in and helping each other out. So that's kind of a unique thing that I have there, but I have, you know, a lot of different spaces that I use to manage different groups of people. And, you know, I hardly ever use my inbox anymore, except for, you know, things that need that digital trail. A lot of my one-to-one interactions, one-liners, all exist inside of this multi-partner, safe, secure space that I have. And then again, as you can tell, I've got my 7-year-old coworker here. And so I've been, you know, teaching a lot of grade one over the past little while. And the ability to, again, communicate on my laptop, this device, that device, whatever my closest device is, to get back to my partners and continue to provide to them what I hope is exemplary customer service, has really made my life a lot easier.
Thanks, Kevin. One more thing I just pulled out of the poll questions that came back was, customers having, you know, bandwidth issues and you know, especially working from home, you know, people have varying levels of bandwidth capability and the neighborhood or the kids' Netflix slows things down. What does Webex do to kind of help mitigate that? And what can you do to kind of create a better user experience, especially where customers might have low or challenging bandwidth issues?
Sure. So again, this is where that analytics hub can become, you know, fairly valuable because, again, I live in downtown Toronto here. I'm blessed with, you know, very high speed internet close to my house. But I work with someone that lives just outside of Guelph, which, if you know Guelph, it's not a small town, and they don't have high speed internet. So again, I'm imagining the IT administrator for that organization who's consistently getting reports from one individual saying, hey, my Webex sucks. But it works fine for everybody else in the organization. And this is through that Webex hub, through the analytics tool, they'd be able to assess, you know, to a certain extent, why is this individual having this poor Webex quality, and customize or create a different, you know, permission, for example, for that individual. So everybody wants to be joining meetings in high definition, but as to whether or not that's always, you know, essential can remain a question. And maybe then we just want to downspeed the permission for that Webex meeting for that individual so that they're not using as much bandwidth for their video and their audio remains constant. As well, actually, a couple of weeks ago, I did a large presentation for our partner community, but because it was very hot and I was getting sick of sitting around the house, I had chosen to go up to the family cottage for a couple of days, which is in a little bit more of a rural environment. So because I have the choice, to be able to use LTE or an audio conferencing service as part of that Webex meeting, I joined the actual Webex meeting on my laptop and shared the PowerPoint on my laptop, but I was on a satellite connection. So if I tried to send my audio through that satellite connection, there was a significant delay because of the fact that I had to send that information up to the satellite, which then beamed it back down, sent it to the NS server back and forth, created almost a 5-second audio delay, which would have worked with syncing with my PowerPoint presentation. So because I had the choice to not use voice over IP only as my audio connection, and I had an audio conferencing service that I could use, I did my audio conferencing over LTE, and that way my voice was synced right up with everybody else's and synced with my PowerPoint, and we didn't get that really weird, awkward voice delay. So again, you know, part of the reason we provide a wide plethora of choice for our customers inside of this collaboration platform so that we can tailor and tweak the collaboration solution to meet those exact needs.
Excellent. Well, if there's no more questions, thank you so much, everybody, for joining. Appreciate the engagement and the connection. Some great questions there. And hopefully this gives you some insights into kind of what's going on with Webex, with the future of where it's going, and hopefully you know how you can see a better opportunity there. Please reach out to Longview at engage@lvs1.com. If you've got any questions or feedback or comments, we'd love to see what we can do to kind of continue to provide value for you around this. And if you'd like a Webex demo, we absolutely have the capability to do a one-on-one demo or set up demo accounts if you don't have Webex already to do that. And certainly, as Kevin mentioned in his presentation, there's a number of new features coming down the pipe very soon that we're excited to see and take advantage of.
Yeah. Yeah, don't take my word for it. You know, don't take anyone else's word for it. There's a lot of fake news out there, although there was none on this call, which is why I'm emphatic about, you know, following up with what Lane said and really, you know, take this stuff for a test drive. It's not a heavy lift at all to get you set up on a trial and, you know, experience it for yourself so you don't have to, you know, rely on hearsay and blogs and even my word. And of course, I'm confident because I know you're going to have a great experience. But yeah, if you guys have any follow-up questions, you should, you know, don't hesitate to reach out to myself or anybody here on this call. Apologize for that small stub toe incident halfway through the call, but I'm sure I'm not the only one who's experienced that over the past 4 months or so. So thanks very much for your time, everyone. And I look forward to seeing those poll answers.
Thanks so much, everybody. Have a great day.